This is part two of how I used PowerPoint to create my Twitter background. I've already resized the landscape slide and I've added a little pizzazz to the background. Now I'll place the graphics. I'll go ahead and insert the bar across the top. I'll use on my drawing toolbar, I'll click the rectangle toolbar and I will draw it out. Now I always, when I'm doing something like this, I like to take the graphic off the slide because I don't want the edges to show. And it just depends on how you're working your design, whether you want to do that or not. Now I'll double click this, and that's when you can choose the fill color that you want to anything, whatever you want. And also the line color. You might want the line to show up, and I might want that. See right here, it's a little darker, and then I can increase the width, or I can just type right in here to increase the thickness of the line. Click OK. And so I'll scroll down to the bottom and I'll add some more squares down here, and I'll resize that. Since this is not a picture, I can just resize it from anywhere actually. And then I'll hold down my control key and make a copy of this. Double click it. I think I'll make it that blue, a blue, dark blue with no line. Click OK. So I have that, and I can play with that. And then you can just add the different layers in, whatever you want to do. I put this at the bottom because on some monitors, when the resolution is different, you might see what's going on in the bottom, and I didn't want that to be plain. So now I'll have to place my picture, but first I want to add the text at the top, tweets about working smarter. So I'll use a text box. Click the text box on the drawing toolbar. And if I click here and bring that down and type, okay, and I'm going to select this text box because I want to change the font to Century Gothic, and I'll make it about 12 point. Maybe that might be too small. I'll try 14 because you do have to play with it a lot. And I'll bring it over, and see, now is a good time for a guide. So I'm going to hold down my control key and hold my mouse over a part of the guide that's not on the slide and make another copy. So I want that to be about there. So now I can use that guide to line this up, and I'll hold down the control key and hit the left arrow key so that I can move it over a little bit at a time. If you don't hold down the control key, it will scoot over in bigger increments, but I wanted it to be very tight increments, so hold down your control key and hit your arrow key on your keyboard, whichever direction you want your things to go. Now I'll change the color. The text box is still selected. I could just reach in and select the text, but I like just selecting the text box. So now I'm going to go down to my drawing toolbar and change the color of the text to, I'll try this dark blue again, and I'll also make it bold, and that should be about right. And then I'll go back and forth changing that if it's not right. Now I'll add my photo. Click the picture toolbar button, and I know where my photos are. Images. These are some photos on my website. Images. And then these are Peggy Duncan photos, and these are publicity shots. And I'll do the 300 dpi because you want to use higher resolution graphics so that your final product will be high resolution. But to be a Twitter background, it can't, your final file can't be over 800 kilobytes. So you might have to resize, and I'll talk about that as well. So I'm going to double click this and move it over. You want your focal point to be on the left side, between right in here, maybe between 9 and 7, maybe 6, but you might have to play with that. So once you install it in onto your Twitter background, you'll see if you need to move it over at all. So then I'll resize that. Now you'll notice this big white box. Of course, I don't want that around there. Now you can use programs like Photoshop to remove that background, or on PowerPoint, if you click the photo to select it, this picture toolbar appears. And this is a transparency tool. If you click that and then hold it over that white background, enough of it might disappear that you can use it. Now this has this little raggedy edge around it, which I don't want that. So once you start to play around with this, I might take this over to Photoshop and lasso some of that out. Or you could change the background behind your photo to be a little lighter, and then this white raggedy stuff would just blend right in there. So you'll have to play around with that. So now I'm going to add the PeggyDuncan.com personal productivity expert, and you would just do that just with a text box and click there, and then you would just change the font size and color just the same way I did when I did the tweets about working smarter. Then you will go over on the right side and insert whatever graphics you want, the same way you did your pictures. Now I inserted some of my books. I inserted copies of my books and some pictures, and I rotated them around just to make them a little bit more funky. Now I'll just insert a rectangle just to show you quickly how I did that. Now you would insert your pictures, of course, like you normally would, but once you get them inserted, if you click them and this little green circle, if you hold your mouse over that green circle, then you can twist things around. You might want to add a shadow to give your photo more depth. Then you would click the shadow style on the drawing toolbar, and I always choose the style 14. And then I also could go into the shadow settings and do some more things. I could nudge it, the shadow up. I could bring it down a little bit. I also could change the color to something else. So play with that. Once you get this going and you think that you might have a winner here, you will want to save this slide as a PNG or a JPEG. So you would just go File, Save As, and down where it says Save As Type, of course you're going to choose where you want to save it. You will do the click down and choose either PNG or JPEG, and I'm going with the PNG. And you give it a reasonable name and click Save. Current side only. Once you save this, if it's not clear and crisp and the quality that you want, because remember, when you save a slide from as a JPEG from PowerPoint, you're copying what's on the monitor, and that's 96 dpi. If you want that higher, you'll want to check out some software that I use when I need higher resolution called RNR Image Export. So that's it for part 2. Part 3, we'll go over to Twitter and add our new graphic and also change Twitter's default background colors.